Let's start this series by discussing the normal structures we see in any B scan. This anterior part is an artifact. Then sometimes we are able to see the posterior surface of the crystalline lens. Then we have here the vitreous cavity. Here we have the layer of retina and choroid. We cannot separate the retina and choroid. They are one layer, except in case of retinal detachment. Then we have this hyperreflective layer of the sclera. Back here we have the optic nerve. There is not much interfaces for the reflection, that's why it appears less refractive. While the surrounding here, it's a higher reflectivity of the loose connective tissue of the orbit, where we have connective tissue, blood vessels, lymphatics, etc. In this figure, you can see here in the orbit, we have two zones of hyperreflectivity. One of them is perpendicular to the globe. The second one is parallel to the globe. Both the optic nerve and the muscle are formed of compact layers. That's why there is not much interfaces inside. In this example, this area is an artifact. This is the vitreous cavity. We have a posterior vitreous detachment here. Notice the choroid and retina are markedly separated or well seen compared to the sclera. Then we have the loose connective tissue of the orbit. We have a muscle here and we have the optic nerve here. In this example, the vitreous cavity shows some echoes and we can see the normal choroid and retina and then the hyperreflective sclera and the loose connective tissue of the orbit. In this example, you can see in the orbital cavity, we have two less refractile zones coming from behind, parallel to the globe at the end. These are two extraocular muscles. This echo is that of the posterior surface of the lens. Sometimes you can see a hyperreflective part in the posterior part of the orbit. This is the bony orbital wall. If an A vector is applied to the B scan, and this is the A vector results, you can notice here the level is zero, denoting a very dark area like this. This is the zero level for us, it's the vitreous cavity. On the other hand, this is the highest refractive part. It's here the highest, this is the 100% refraction. This is the back wall of the eye. In this example, some echoes in the vitreous, not much high. This is the high refractive part. This is the muscle. You can see it has some refractions. So this is the end of this part of my presentation.